So I'm going to show a little bit of the clip of, not even the whole clip because it's very long, but it's actually Agnes DeMille's choreography that she recreated for the film, and Oliver recreated his set with the beautiful skies. And then after that, I'm going to show what's left of Porgy and Bess. Now, Porgy and Bess, I'll tell you, the problem with Porgy and Bess clip is that it was not part of the original MGM library, but it's always been under litigation, both by the Gershwin estate, who didn't like it. I shouldn't say litigation from them, but they never approved it, and they don't sanction it. And so it's not released anywhere in a good format. Evidently, there's a good print of it in Germany, but anyway, long story short, this is, I will make big apologies for this clip, but this clip does show the sets. You can see how they were whitewashed and then repainted. So why don't we, if we can, Leo, show the both clips back to back, and then for those of you that want to stay for a very brief Q&A, we'll have that. So this next one is Oklahoma, which Oliver did back to back with Guys and Dolls, and he did the press junket the same year, which was 55 in New York and around the country. And the funny thing was that there's some funny stories about him. They would ask him questions about Guys and Dolls, but all he wanted to talk about was Oklahoma. And they asked him questions about Oklahoma, all he wanted to talk about was Guys and Dolls. So those two pictures were done sort of in tandem, one right after the other. And then 4 years later, Oliver came back at the request of Sam Goldwyn, who had then left MGM. And that's part of the problem with the MGM print, because it wasn't technically in the MGM library, and now it's owned by Warner Brothers, and Warner Brothers won't release it because they're also afraid of the sort of weird, it's weird patronage. So that's why we have a very big problem with Porgy and Bess. And on top of that, Otto Preminger didn't want Sam Goldwyn to recut it. So he shot almost the entire movie in CinemaScope, in widescreen, with no close-ups. So he didn't give him the opportunity to recut the film because all he had was what they had. So I think in this scale you can see it, but when it's reduced down to our smaller screens that we see today, it's not very good. So anyway, without further ado, it's about 5 or 6 minutes or less of Oklahoma and 2 minutes of Porgy and Bess. Porgy and Bess is 1959, which is a significant year for Oliver.